Respected chairpersons, friends, and colleagues, the title of my talk today is Vitrification of Embryos. Now, the ultimate aim of any ART procedure is the birth of a single live healthy baby, which can be achieved through an elective single embryo transfer. So, consequently, if we want to proceed to a single embryo transfer and even reduce the number of embryos that we transfer, optimizing our cryopreservation program is essential. So now, in the last decade of 15 years, certainly many centers are using vitrification instead of slow freezing. As vitrification technologies have improved their success profiles, new applications seem to have emerged, making IVF treatments more successful and flexible. So in my talk today, I'm going to briefly discuss the need to reduce the number of embryos being transferred, and then I'm going to look at vitrification as an approach to prevent OHSs, and I'm going to look at vitrification paired with minimal stimulation. We need to be aware of the drawbacks of transferring multiple embryos at a time. The main drawback is, of course, multiple pregnancy. But we also have to remember that when we transfer more embryos, we are also wasting embryos. I think we all need to reassess what we call a successful IVF outcome. Triplet babies who spend months in the NICU and who might end up with lifelong complications is no longer considered a successful IVF outcome. So that gets us to the question, how do we reduce multiple pregnancies when we are creating so many beautiful embryos with controlled ovarian stimulation?